Let's talk now to former Philippine Olympic Committee Chairman Monico Puentevella for his thoughts on the country's hosting of the 30th SEA Games. Mr. Puentevella, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron, and good afternoon to everybody.
Hi, sir. You're calling this year's organizers amateurs because of the problems that have cropped up. Now, who do you think could have handled the hosting better and why?
Well, if you ask me personally, and maybe I'm a bit biased, the 2005 will probably be the best Southeast Asian Games hosting this country's ever had, especially now that we have started with some things on the wrong foot, some events on the wrong foot. You see, in 2005, we only had a budget of about 500 million pesos, including infra. And now we have 7.5 billion pesos for the games and about 13 billion pesos for infra. So that's about 20 billion pesos compared to 500 million pesos. But we run away with the first ever victory, landslide, for the first time in Philippine history for the SEA Games in 2005. This is what happened. And I guess the problem I can see now, Ron, is actually too many cooks spoiling the broth. You see, there are now three different groups hosting the games. You have PSC for government support, POC for the athletes and officials, and PILSGO for the hosting only. Now, in 2005, POC was handling PILSOC, but it was all POC. And so mainly it was just POC and PEC. The foundation was made up of POC members themselves. In this case now, today, we have POC handling the athletes, PSC handling the money, but PISGOG is hosting and organizing the games. So, to start this talk with you, I would rather have the good news first, that surely we will win these games, for sure, hands down ito.
You're still optimistic about that, sir. Why? Why are you still optimistic about that?
Because we created 56 events instead of 40, the biggest in SEA Games history, because we know that by having more events, we will have more goals. Like, artists was never there before, esports was never there before, and we chose events which definitely will give us gold. So, whether there's a small, well, for me, it will surely be a landslide victory, no matter what. That's the good news. Mm-hmm. But you have to thank PEC and POC only, because PEC and POC, PSC did everything to send everybody abroad for international exposure, while POC handled all the athletes, which is our main obligation. PISCO only comes in to host the games. That is the big difference between the three.
Okay.
For sure, that's the good news. We'll win hands down. But again, when you say that this was envisioned to be the best ever in SEA Games history, I think it will probably come down to be one of the worst.
Okay, let's talk about the problems that have cropped up. And as you mentioned, the POC during that time, which you chaired during the 2005 SEA Games, was part of the organizing team for the games then. But didn't you encounter the same problems that have been that athletes are complaining about this year? Logistics, meals, accommodation, transportation, unfinished venues. Didn't those problems occur also during 2005?
The basic problem here, honestly, is because the people working now had no experience whatsoever in the 2000 running of the games. This is a completely new group. And at that time, the one running the games were POC people themselves, even if there was a foundation, and PSA was there to assist. But this time, the PISCO is made up of people who are outside the sports arena. The basic problem is they did not get any advice from the people who did the 2005 spectacle that really was the first time we won in history. And we offered our help. I offered my help to Secretary and Speaker Alan, but I'm sorry, I don't think they wanted anybody's help from POC. They wanted to run this thing by themselves, and they probably felt confident they can do it, but that's the basic problem. They have no experience.
Mr. Puentevella, let's go back to 2005. I was asking about the problems then. What were the major problems during the 2005 holding of the CBN?
We had no problems because at that time I was the congressman and I was the one who actually convinced President Arroyo to make the commitment because it was a commitment. It was our turn, unlike now that we came in place of Brunei. This is not our turn to host the game. Brunei, but we took the initiative when Brunei said they couldn't do it. We came forward and volunteered to take the place of Brunei. At that time, since we didn't have enough money, President Arroyo did not want to push through, but we were able to convince her, and I was a congressman then, and it turned out very well. We didn't have any problems, Ron. I think for a while there was some, the smallest problem was letting the athletes ride the jeepney because we wanted them to feel the Philippine jeepney, how it works. But in the end, we stuck up with the best bus transit, which is Ceres Vallecar. But now, if you see, the problem is quite huge. You have a problem with transport, arrivals, welcoming the athletes, you have hotel problems, you have food problems. We had no problems like this before.
Don't you think
there should have been no problem now if they only got people who had experience in the 2005 South Asian Games?
Lastly, Mr. Puentevella,
I can see
with those statements, you are expecting more problems to come up during the opening ceremonies and during the holding of the whole games until it finishes.
Well, honestly and personally, I hope there will be no more problems, but it's quite embarrassing that even our own athletes, women's football and other teams, are the ones complaining. And if it's not acceptable to our own national athletes, what more for the other countries who are here to play? That's why, you know, I've been in all SEA Games, Asian Games, Olympics. We never had this treatment before in other countries. That's why it's not good to say, oh, this happened in other countries. What does that mean? Because it happened in other countries, you are going to do it also. You could have, you know, and the problem is the hype when they said, the games, we are ready for the games. So now what happened suddenly? There are, you know, what we have are amateurs.